Okay, we've got enough of the intrigue. Now here I am with my new hair. Hello everyone, my name is Maria. Welcome back to Awful Girl. I finally came up with a nice phrase to say at the beginning of my videos. The name of this video is Sauce, just to attract attention, but actually because of my brain is just a very messy place and my brain is very extra. So every time I come up with some interesting idea, I have to, my not even me, my brain has to go extra every time. So instead of just naming this something like chatting with Maria, girly talks with awful girl, I have to be like, no, we will call this sauce or spilling out salt because we just can't do that. We just can't come up with this. Though I'm kind of still thinking about whether it's a good name or not. Is it too extra or is it okay? But we're going to figure that out a bit later. And so, such rubrics are almost one of my most favorites on like the whole YouTube. Rubrics like that, where your favorite YouTuber just sits in front of the camera and just speaks about everything they feel, what was happening with them. They are just talking. It's basically just a monologue, which is kind of like a dialogue. Such videos are just so nice because they allow you to actually understand how a person thinks outside of like any action, outside of any situations. It's just like bare thinking, the bare inside of the human's brain. Inside of my brain is kinda, it's a lot of mess, it's a lot of K-pop. But at the end of the day, I hope it will be entertaining and funny and interesting for most of the people out there. Okay, so basically what I'm going to do in this video, I'm going to just whine about 2020 and how terrible it was for everybody, of course, and for me personally. But before we're going into 2020 and how terrible it is, let's just take another second of appreciation to my new haircut because this is the shortest hair I've had in 7 years of my life. Is it me glitching or had the door just opened? Now we also have demons haunting me. Back on track. I'm in love with it. The first time the hairdresser just cut all of my hair and I just started moving my head and I was feeling almost dizzy because I think people with long hair will understand. When you have long hair, when you turn your head, when you move it around, it still feels like you're moving your whole body. It's like a work to actually turn your head, especially if your hair is very long and heavy, as mine was. And then, oh my God, it was such a relief where I can do this and my head and my neck won't hurt because of that, because my hair is just so airy and wonderful. I just love it so much. If you need an inspiration or some sign to just go and cut your hair, this is it. Go for it. Okay, so now to depression, anxiety, and other things. So how y'all doing? I probably shouldn't ask because from like all conversations which are going on in my life with different people, I can understand that everybody are just constantly feeling bad nowadays. And I'm not an exclusion. I mean, like lately, I've been feeling the best of I don't know, of the past half a year, I think. Or whenever since the quarantine started, maybe. The thing is that since everybody, the whole family is basically just stuck at home, everybody are just around each other all the time. My mom is at home, my dad is working from home, and my brother now lives with me in one room. And this moving was just such a huge stress for me. I just couldn't realize how to live in a new environment, what to do, how to spend my days, what are my routines now. It was a huge work to figure it all out. And because of everybody around and I'm just kind of looking at people, are they okay? And everybody seem okay at home. And I feel bad, and then I just start feeling bad for feeling bad because when I feel bad, I actually have no motivation, no wish, and no proper mood to do something very active and very, what's that word, and something very productive. And I just start feeling bad about this because everybody at home are always busy with something. My brother is playing, my mom is working, my dad is working, and I'm just like, okay, I'm feeling bad right here. Only recently, like I don't know, half a month ago, I gave myself a break and I just like woke up all that compassion to myself inside of myself, because I realized that I was going on such a bottom of my personality. And so only recently I've just realized that I have to just stop and just to be compassionate and loving about myself and with myself. Because I've seen this video of Lavender about a week ago, and it appeared to me as a very nice summarization of everything I was thinking and trying to collect inside of me lately. It's just about, these are hard times, you just have to go very slow, you just have to give you that break, you just have to be very, very gentle with yourself, because in this time, at these times, it's very easy to break, and it's very easy to break yourself, especially. Yeah, and adding to that, there is such thing about your birthday and life energy. So I don't know if you believe in this, but I really do believe in this, because I've been getting a lot of evidence that it is true, at least for me. There is like a calendar year, which is like from the 1st of January to the 31st of December. And there is also another year, which is like year from your birthday till your birthday. And this year actually is like a cycle of your life energy. So on your birthday, your life energy actually goes on zero. It's like a complete reboot. You just start everything over. And like on the first day after your birthday, you start getting your life energy back. It just starts flowing back to your body, mind, soul, etc., etc. And then you get the peak of like your life energy half a year from your birthday. And the very funny thing about mine, this such a life cycle, that my maximum of my energy is always on February 14th, which is like Valentine's Day, and I've never got a boyfriend in my life. And so every year is like, oh, I'm flowing with all my energy and nice and positive vibes, I'm my best this day, and no one to spill it to. It's very ironic thing. My life is ironic. And so from that half a year, from my 14th February till your birthday, your energy is going from like 100 to zero. And so that's why a lot of the times you can get sick on your birthday, and you can just feel very moody and so on and so on. How this, the lowest part of my birthday year has been for me this year, get comfortable. It's going to be a very stressful storytelling. So first of all, yeah, my acne, it got so much better now. I finally got a normal instruction what to do with all of that. I was prescribed birth control pills. I was also prescribed an antibiotic for especially for fighting an acne, and I'm finishing it. It's just 6 days at this point left. And also my mom has got a client who is a cosmetologist, and she just really helped me with my skincare routine. She told me what to use for my face, and I feel like it's finally, little by little, my face is getting a bit better in small steps, but this is so much better than it was, like, especially in the video about acne, that was like one of the worst moments with all of that. Now it's getting better. I'm praying to the universe every day that it's not getting worse. I'm trying my best. I'm using sunscreen. It's just, we're fighting it. Fighting for everybody who's fighting acne. We can do this. And also, the acne was kind of an ongoing problem, but the very interesting thing that one lovely summer day when my brother got back from the kindergarten he's going to, he just started, his nose was a bit runny and he was coughing a bit, and we just thought, oh, it looks like an allergy, everything will be fine. But in the next week, my mom got sick, I got sick, and my dad got sick. And if everything was pretty much okay for everybody, they just got better, I've got a sinusitis. Yay! Sinusitis is basically when you have pus in this part of your nasal canals in this part of your face, and you cannot breathe. You have not even like a runny nose, you have a pus running from your nose, and there is a difference, and I wish you'll never know that difference. And it basically feels like dying. The first 2 days when I've realized that no, it doesn't seem like an allergy anymore, it doesn't seem like a virus anymore, I couldn't sleep the first night, on the second night the second night when it got very, very bad, I just woke up in the middle of the night realizing that I turned to my back and I couldn't breathe, and to the degree that I felt like there is kind of like a screen inside of my face which is blocking my nose from my breathing system, and every time I was trying to swallow I felt that screen inside of my face kind of like moving with my swallowing. And the first thought which I've got when I woke up in the middle of the night being unable to breathe is, great, I have a coronavirus and I'm dying, I think. They were like 5 seconds with this thought, and then I just realized maybe it's not a coronavirus, but I still feel like shit. And so the very next morning we went to the urgent care, and it's like a separate story to tell. We spent 4 hours instead of 1.5 to 2 hours in our car waiting for our scheduled appointment. Then we got really, really bad doctor who barely prescribed me antibiotics. And when you have pus in your freaking face, the first thing you have to do is just to start drinking antibiotics so you're not getting your face destroyed and like your whole breathing system destroyed. This is like the basics. And if not my mom, she wouldn't even care to prescribe me antibiotics. It was terrible. And that day I didn't have a breakfast and I low-key felt like dying because you know when it's in your face it's also a headache, you cannot breathe, I just felt terrible. And I was barely prescribed antibiotics, but I was tested for COVID-19. And I think you could have seen it like everywhere how you're being tested for COVID-19, but it's basically like, I don't even know how to call it. It's such a thing, a very long and a very painful thing, which goes down your nose back to your throat. And after this procedure, you basically feel like throwing up, you feel raped, and it doesn't feel nice at all because it feels like something very, very hot being put into your nose, and this is inside of your brain. It felt like that stick was basically going straight to my brain. And I was even lucky that day because the right side of my nose wasn't breathing at all. And she was like, okay, maybe because of that, we'll just take the COVID test with this part of your nose and we're just going to make one test. And so I was prescribed antibiotics. I started drinking them, and then later, like a couple of days later, I went to my actual physician and doctor to talk about my acne and checkup. That was already my doctor, my new doctor, nice doctor, not that random woman which we've got in that clinic. And she basically prescribed me another antibiotic for my face and the birth control. And then after 2 antibiotics, now my body is really, really stressed. I've got another problem about which I'm not going to speak. But yeah. And also the very interesting thing after sinusitis is that your tan receptors, which are basically telling you what's the taste of the food you're eating, they've got really nuts. And so a lot of food I was eating was of a very weird taste, and or it was just not tasty for me at all. I was like, ew, it smells like ammoniac. Do you call it ammoniac? Something really weird. I don't like it. And they were like my favorite foods, which I really, really adoring before the sinusitis. And that's it for the sinusitis story. So yeah, that's my 2020 so far. Tomorrow I will die from dynamite, and I feel like I will come back to life again, completely renewed. Oh, and also for the past week, it's been terrible by the means of the air quality in Colorado, because the half of America is basically in fire. And because of that, we have a constant smell of smoke in the air. We have like a very weird colored skies. They are not blue anymore. They are, I don't know, white or gray or whatever. It feels like I live in Ukraine, Zaporozhye again. It's the city I was born in, and it's a very industrial city. So skies were like that in my city almost like most of the year. Coming in Colorado, it was like, wow, the sky is so blue. Now I'm back to my motherland again. Even no reason to feel homesick again, because it's like at home. Half of America is on fire. We get a red sky not during sunsets and sunrises anymore. We get it in the middle of the day because of the smoke covering the sun. 2020 is going to kill us. Why did I say all of that to you? So you just can realize if your life is better right now for you, then you're a very happy person. I just want you to realize that. If your life is worse, well, first of all, I'm sorry. Second of all, though our struggles cannot be compared, we're still in the same boat. We still all feel like, let's just try to survive that together. The next year will be better. We'll get better. We'll get better. I believe in something. In something nice is going to happen with all of us. For example, me learning how to speak English. It will be so great. I've just realized my bullet point list is kind of over, and that most of the time, 90% of the time of this video, I was just whining about how everything bad is for me in 2020. I'm sorry. It's kind of where we all are at right now, so I really hope it's not that bad for you. Or if it is as bad for you, I just hope that you find your way out. Just cut your hair, I don't know, paint it blue, whatever will make you feel better. Change something about your routine, start reading a book, start a YouTube channel, because it's a way to get into that wonderful world of something very unusual. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you're well. I wish you to be happy. I wish you to keep your sanity and think about yourself and your mental health first. And please be happy, and please remember that you are loved by this universe, even if you cannot feel it. I'm sorry for whining again. I love you though.